Carolyn called me from the plane right before they were taking off. And I think it was probably a little bit after 8 o'clock. I don't remember anything really important from that conversation. I didn't certainly think it would be the last time I would speak to my friend. When I first met John, we were sharing a summer house in Sagaponack, and he walked out of the bedroom very sort of self-possessed and friendly and introduced himself as John Kennedy, I believe. That he was wearing his underwear had no bearing on the the situation. He was just to me Anthony's cousin, in spite of the fact that he was probably the most famous, recognizable face in the world. The next weekend, he came to the beach house with Carolyn. I remember in the morning waking up and walking out into the living room, and there she was, all 6 feet of her, blonde, beautiful, these big blue eyes. I've never seen bigger, bluer eyes in my life, and I was quite taken aback. She had the ease that a lot of very beautiful women have, and she immediately knew to make it comfortable. And she came over, I think she hugged me. Hi, I'm Carolyn, with John. I don't know, it was just, I think she commented on my outfit. I was wearing red denim shorts and they were belted. I don't know, I thought I was cool. And she said, oh, I love your red denim shorts. Carolyn had a theory. The best relationships were worth waiting for. I think her analogy was you're standing on a beach and you see something in the ocean that you want. You could either wait patiently for the tide to bring it to you, or you could splash around and try to get it. And she always thought that the relationships that you waited patiently for were the only ones worth having. And I could see that. I could see that in her relationship with John, and I could see that in her relationship with me.
At this hour, here is what we know.
The plane was gone.
Search and rescue efforts.
I wanted to keep hope alive.
I think we have a chance to find something else.
How did you let this get so out of control?